DJI Transmission Standard Combo Tutorial, Using for the First Time. In this video, we will walk you through the first use tips of DJI Transmission Combo. Open the protector case, and you will find a DJI video transmitter, a DJI video receiver, a USB-C power cable, two NPF battery adapters, an installation toolkit, an SDI cable, a DC to PTAP power cable, two WB37 battery adapters, two Ronin video transmission antenna, a USB-C cable, a WB37 battery charging hub, two WB37 intelligent batteries, and an RS gimbal mounting plate. Install the WB37 intelligent battery into DJI video receiver. Press the power button to turn the receiver on, wait for the menu page to appear, and the startup process is complete. Select a preferred language when using for the first time. Before the first use, connect the video receiver to a computer for activation via the USB-C cable. Prior to activation, please update the receiver firmware to the latest version as prompted by DJI Assistant 2, Ronin-series. Click the video receiver icon and enter your DJI account and password to log in for activation. Click Firmware Update in DJI Assistant 2, Ronin-series. You can view the current firmware version in use and all available firmware. Select the firmware version you need and click Update. When the progress bar is fully filled, finish the update. There are four detachable antennas on the top and both sides of DJI video receiver. On the left side of the video receiver, from top to down, are as follows. Power button. Press the power button once to power on the receiver, and press and hold it to power off the device. Display screen. Displays the device status and menu. Menu dial. Press the dial to access the menu and confirm settings. Turn to switch between options. In control mode, press and hold to enter linking status. And double-click to choose a channel. In broadcast mode, press and hold to search for devices. And double-click to select the device number. Back button. Press to return to the previous screen of the menu. Check the upper right corner of the video receiver to see the video status indicator and linking status indicator. On the right side of the video receiver, from top to down, are SDI output port and HDMI port for outputting video signals. USB-C port supports connecting to a computer or headsets with a USB-C port. DCN port supplies power to the video receiver using the provided DC to PTAP power cable. The connect pins on the back of the video receiver can be used to connect WB37 or NPF battery adapter. Two quarter-inch 20 screw holes and one 3/8-inch screw hole on the bottom of the video receiver can be used for fixing or mounting the video receiver. When the receiver is linked and connected to an input source, the top left corner of the display screen shows the video resolution and frame rate of the input, while the top right corner displays the battery voltage. In control mode, from top to bottom, are control A or B, channel and use, and channel signal quality. There are two statuses, including strong, green, and weak, red. In broadcast mode, the device number and channel in use are displayed from top to bottom. The video transmission signal strength and frame rate are also displayed at the bottom. There are three statuses for the video transmission signal strength, including strong, green, moderate, orange, and weak, red. Press and hold the menu dial on the DJI video receiver to enter the menu. Connection mode offers control mode and broadcast mode. Channel. Tap to choose a channel, and the color dot on the right indicates the current channel signal quality. Device number. In broadcast mode, displays the device number of the transmitter device. You are allowed to switch between devices or refresh the search results. Fan mode. Set the fan mode to standard or low noise. Type-C function. Set the Type-C function to USB or voice call. Select USB when using the USB-C port for activation or a firmware update in DJI Assistant 2. When set to voice call, it supports connecting headphones via the USB-C port to enable voice calls between the transmitter and receiver. Low latency. You can enable or disable low latency mode. The frame rate will be converted to 60 FPS when enabled, and it will follow the camera's output frame rate when this mode is disabled. Language. You can choose between Chinese or English. Device info. View information such as the device SN and firmware version. Please refer to the DJI Transmission First Use tutorial for an introduction to the display screen menu on DJI Video Transmitter. Thank you for watching.